for a hot and dry weather condition, we call such a system as summer air conditioning system designed for hot and dry weather. So this is the description of summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather. So I would like to attract the attention of the students. In the examination, this question could be asked in such a way that it will be asked to describe the working principle of summer air conditioning system with the help of a neat sketch. So what you are supposed to do? Three things you are supposed to do. First thing is, you should draw the flow diagram or the circuit diagram of summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather properly. The second thing is, you should represent the various processes involved in the summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather properly on a psychrometric chart. So how many processes are involved? In fact, there are only two processes which are involved. One is the sensible cooling process between 1 to 2. The other one is the adiabatic humidification process between 2 to 3 or 2 to 5. 2 to 5 is nothing but excess amount of water vapor addition, whereas actual process is 2 to 3 only. That is adiabatic humidification process. So these two processes are to be represented properly on the psychrometric chart. Third thing to be done is, you should write the proper description explaining the working of summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather. So these are the things what is expected out of you if at all such a question is asked in the examination. Okay, now let us come to the next one, which we call it as summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather. So now let us try to discuss the working principle of summer air conditioning system for hot and humid weather or for hot and wet weather. So how do we define that? We will see now. First we will consider the different components involved in the system. Summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather consists of these components. So what are the components? Again, there are dampers, there is an air filter, and there is a cooling coil. But this cooling coil is placed on a chamber known as dwell. What is the meaning of dwell? In fact, it can be considered as a well also. The cooling coil is placed on a chamber or on a well. Then after that, there is a heating coil also. So what are the different components of summer air conditioning system used for hot and wet weather? It is nothing but the dampers, there is an air filter, there is a cooling coil placed over a chamber or placed over a well. After that, there is a heating coil also. Now let us see how exactly the summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather or for hot and humid weather is going to work. So again, the air enters the air conditioning system through dampers. What kind of air enters here? The kind of air which is entering here is hot and humid. What do you mean by saying air is hot and humid? The temperature of air is very high. At the same time, the relative humidity of air is also very high. The temperature may be of the order of, as we have taken in the example, the temperature may be of the order of 38 degrees centigrade or 39 degrees centigrade, and the relative humidity is maybe of the order of around 80%, 90%. So hot and humid air passes through the air conditioning system. First, again, it passes through the dampers. As we have discussed already in the previous working principle, the dampers are nothing but the doors which are used to control the amount of air getting admitted into the system. So if you increase the distance between the two dampers, more amount of air gets admitted into the system. If you decrease the distance, between the two dampers, less amount of air gets admitted into the system. So that means that the amount of air getting admitted into the system can be controlled with the help of the dampers. Then the air passes through the air filter. As we have already discussed in the previous section, so again, in the filter, the dust particles from the air are removed. Any contaminated particles or dust particles from the air are removed in the air filter. Then this hot and humid air then passes through the cooling coil. Now I think, students, please note that this is the key part of this particular air conditioning system. There are two things happening here during this particular section. What are the two things? when the air passes through the cooling coil, since the air is a hot air, when it passes through around the coil, cooling coil, so the air is going to reject its heat to the cooling medium. That cooling medium is water, which is flowing through the tubes of the cooling coil. So first of all, the air is going to reject its heat to the cooling coil. Because of that, the temperature of air decreases. In addition to that, since the air is already humid, since it has got excess amount of water vapors, those excess amount of water vapors are removed from the air and it is collected in the well or in this container. So the water which is removed, excess amount of water which is removed from the air, is collected in this container or is collected in this well. So how to represent this process on the psychrometric chart? Please note that there are two things happening. First thing is, it is a cooling process. During the cooling process of air, since the air is going to reject its heat to the cooling medium in the cooling coil, the temperature of air should decrease. And since the excess amount of water particles are removed from the air, so that is why the humidity level of air should also decrease. That means two things are happening in this particular section. One is, temperature of air is decreasing. The second thing is, the specific humidity is also decreasing. How exactly we take that? There are two ways in which you can take that. Students, please note that. Now let me explain that with respect to the psychrometric chart. If you move from 1 to here, saturation curve, that is the cooling process. From this point in the saturation curve, if you move to the point 2, that is known as the dehumidification process. So two things are happening in this section. One is cooling, the other one is removal of water, excess amount of water from the air, which we call it as the dehumidification process. So in the psychrometric chart, this process can be represented in two different ways. One is, you can move from the point 1 horizontally up to saturation curve. So if you move along this horizontally up to the saturation curve, that is known as cooling. Again, from the saturation curve, in the saturation curve, from this point to point 2, if you move, that is known as dehumidification process. You know that during this process, during the process from point 1 to, when you move horizontally, temperature of air is decreasing. And when you move along the saturation curve downwards, the specific humidity is also decreasing. Either you can show the process as cooling, then dehumidification like this, or directly you can move from 1 to 2 also like this. If you move directly from 1 to 2, what is happening? Consider the process 1 to 2 once for all. What is happening during the process 1 to 2 once for all? During the process 1 to 2, the temperature is decreasing from TD1 to TD2, and the specific humidity is also decreasing from WO1 to WO2. That means that in this section, when the air, which is a hot and humid air, when it passes through the cooling coil, two things are happening. One is the cooling process, by rejecting, the air is going to reject its heat to the cooling medium, thereby temperature of air is decreasing. Since the excess amount of water vapors are removed from the air, we call it as dehumidification process. Specific humidity of air also decreases. So now the air which is coming out of the cooling coil is at a low temperature, also at a lower value of specific humidity. But since, of course, it is at a low temperature now, but it is at a very, very low temperature. It may not be around 25 degree, 26 degree. It may be at a very, very low temperature. But even though specific humidity decreases, but the relative humidity is not decreased. Please see the psychrometric chart, which is the end of the process. Process point 2 is the end of the process. So if point 2 is the end of the process, at the point 2 still the relative humidity is higher. So that is why, to decrease the relative humidity, also to increase the temperature, what we do is, the air which is coming out of the cooling coil, we make it to pass through a heating coil. When you make the air to pass through a heating coil, the heating of air takes place with the help of the heating coil. So during this process, the temperature of air increases, even the relative humidity decreases, but this heating takes place at a constant specific humidity value from 3 to 4. So it takes place at a constant specific humidity value 3 to 4. So such a process we call it as heating process. That means the air which comes out of the heating coil, it should, in fact, it comes out of the heating coil at 5, it should have come out of the heating coil at 4, but in the actual practice, it comes out of the heating coil at the 8.5. So when it comes out of the heating coil, the air is said to be conditioned, and this air which is conditioned is passed through a space known as the air conditioned space. So, and it is used for the required purposes in the air conditioned space. So that means that what is that we have achieved in this design process? In the design of summer air conditioning system used for hot and humid condition or hot and wet condition, there are two processes we have come across. One is the cooling and dehumidification process represented by the process 1 to 2. The other one is the heating process. What is happening during the cooling and dehumidification process? During the cooling and dehumidification process, the temperature of air is decreasing from TD1 to TD2 and the specific humidity is decreasing from WO1 to WO2. In fact, theoretically, it should have decreased from WO1 to WO2, but in the actual practice, it decreases from WO1 to WO3. So at the 8.3, the air enters the heating coil, and in the heating coil, further heating of air takes place at constant specific humidity, that is represented by the process 3-4 or 3-5. So during this process, the specific humidity remains constant, but the temperature increases from TD3 to TD4 or TD5, whereas the relative humidity decreases. In fact, during the process 3 to 4, the air should have come out at the 0.4, but in the actual practice, it comes out at the 0.5. So, if the students, if you ask me, sir, why it comes out at the 0.5, why it not come out at the 0.4? Also, if you ask me, at the end of the humidification process, dehumidification process, it should have come out, the air should have come out at 2, but instead it is coming out at 3. Why is it coming out at 3? If you ask me that question, I will try to answer that question. So please note that the air which is getting admitted into the air conditioning system, you know, let us assume that 15 meter cube of air is passing through the air conditioning system. Do you think that all 15 meter cube of air passes through the cooling coil? All 15 meter cube of air, will it pass through the heating coil? No, it will not pass through. So, if you get admitted 15 meter cube of air into the air conditioning system, all 15 meter cube of air may not pass through the cooling coil. All 15 meter cube of air may not pass through the heating coil. So, certain amount of air or certain volume of air without passing through the cooling coil, without passing through the heating coil, may go out of the air conditioning system simply like that. So, that this air which simply goes like that, we call that as bypass air. So, since some certain amount of air is bypassed without passing through the cooling coil, neither passing through the heating coil, that is why even though theoretically air should have come out of the cooling coil at 2, instead of coming out of the cooling coil at 2, it comes out of the cooling coil at 3. Similarly, instead of air coming out of the heating coil at 4, it comes out of the heating coil at 5, because certain volume of air is bypassed without passing through the cooling coil, neither passing through the heating coil. So this is about the working principle of summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather or for hot and humid weather. Now you know that this kind of bypass has happened even in the previous system also. So what is that previous system? You know that in the summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather, first the air was passing through the cooling coil. Here also, air should have come out of the cooling coil at the 0.4, but instead it is coming out of the cooling coil at the 0.2 only. So air should have passed through, the cooling process should have ended at the 0.4, but it is getting ended at the 0.2 only in reality. Why that is happening? Because if 15 meter cube of air is passing through the air conditioning system, all 15 meter cube doesn't pass through the cooling coil, neither pass through the adiabatic humidifier. certain amount of air without passing through this, right, gets absconded, gets bypassed. So that is why instead of air coming out of the cooling coil at 4, it comes out of the cooling coil at 2. Then after that, it passes through the adiabatic humidifier. So we have already discussed now then the working of summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather, also the working of summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather. Again, I repeat, you know, if at all this question is asked in the examination, what are the three things you should write? First thing what you should write is the flow diagram of summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather. The second thing what you should mention is the representation of the processes on the psychrometric chart. So in the second system, what are the processes involved? One is cooling and dehumidification process. Next one is heating process. 1 to 3 or 1 to 2 is the cooling and dehumidification process, and 3 to 4 or 3 to 5 is the heating process in the heating coil. So first you should draw the schematic diagram or the flow diagram of the system. Then you should represent the various processes on the psychrometric chart. After that, you should also write the proper description for the summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather. Okay, well now let us consider the last air conditioning system, which we call it as the winter air conditioning system. So now this is the schematic diagram of a winter air conditioning system, and this is the representation of the processes in the winter air conditioning system. So in this, now first let us try to identify once again the various components of the winter air conditioning system. Again, in the winter air conditioning system, as I already mentioned, when do we go for the design of winter air conditioning system? That is in the winter season. During the winter season, what happens? The air temperature is very less. It may be of the order of 10 degree, 14 degree, 15 degree, or even maybe 5 degree, 8 degree, depending upon the particular place, depending upon the season. So the temperature is very less. The relative humidity may also be very less only. So what is our aim here? Our aim here is to increase the temperature to 25 to 26 degrees centigrade, also to increase the humidity level to 50 to 60%. So the system which is designed for such a purpose, we call it as a winter air conditioning system. So these are the components available for a winter air conditioning system. Again, it consists of dampers, there is a filter, there is a heating coil, again there is a chamber known as adiabatic humidifier, and there is a component known as water eliminator. And after the water eliminator, there is one more heating coil. That means in this system, how many heating coils are there? There are two heating coils which are present in this particular system. So again, let me repeat the components. There are dampers, there is a filter, there is a heating coil, there is a chamber known as adiabatic humidifier, there is a component known as water eliminator, and there is one more heating coil. So these are the components involved in the winter air conditioning system. Now let us try to consider the working principle. As we have already discussed, the air which is having a very less temperature, also at a very low value of specific humidity, very low value of relative humidity, passes through the air conditioning system through dampers. Again, the amount of air getting admitted into the system can be controlled with the help of dampers, either by increasing the distance between the two dampers or by decreasing the distance between the two dampers. You can either increase the amount of air getting admitted into the system, or you can decrease the amount of air getting admitted into the system. So by controlling, by adjusting the distance between the two dampers, you can control the amount of air getting admitted into the system. Then the air passes through the filter, where the contaminated particles and the dust particles from the air are removed in the filter. Now the air which has got a very less temperature also has got a very low value of specific humidity, very low value of specific humidity, passes through the heating coil. So in the heating coil, sensible heating of air takes place. That is what you are able to see in the psychrometric chart. 1 to 2 is the sensible heating process in the heating coil. In fact, again I have told you in the previous two sections, actual heating should have been 1 to 3. Theoretical heating should have been from 1 to 3. But in practice, in the actual practice, heating is taking place only between 1 to 2. Why it is not taking place between 1 to 3? Again, entire volume of air is not passing through the heating coil. Some amount of air is bypassing. Since some amount of air is bypassing, instead of ending the heating process at 3, we are ending the heating process at 2 only. So the process 1 to 2 is the sensible heating of air taking place in the heating coil. During this sensible heating process, the temperature of air increases from TD1 to TD2. So the air whose temperature is increased from TD1 to TD2, but whose relative humidity is decreased and whose specific humidity value doesn't change, passes through a chamber known as adiabatic humidifier. We already know that this kind of adiabatic humidifier was also used in the first system. That is, you know that we have already used that in the summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather. So what is that we do in the adiabatic humidifier? We try to spray certain amount of water through perforations with the help of pumps. Water is supplied to the pump, through the pump here, but with the help of perforations or nozzles, we are going to spray the water to the incoming air. By spraying the water to the incoming air, the specific humidity of air increases from 2 to 3. Even the relative humidity also increases from 2 to 3. So, you know that the specific humidity increases from 2 to 5. Also, the specific humidity increases from 2 to 5. Relative humidity also increases from 2 to 5. But at the same time, most important thing to be noted is adiabatic humidifier is the device which is designed in such a way that no change in the heat content in this device for the air. So that means that this process 2 to 5 takes place at constant enthalpy, or the process is known as adiabatic humidification process. During this process, even though there is an increase in specific humidity, even though there is an increase in the relative humidity, but the enthalpy remains constant. So the air which is coming out of the adiabatic humidifier may contain excess amount of water vapors with it. So these excess amount of water vapors are removed in the device known as water eliminator. When the excess amount of water vapors are removed, the state point comes down from 5 to 4. That means that the air leaves the water eliminator at the point 4. So the air which is leaving the water eliminator at the state point 4 is having a lower value of temperature, but that is not 25 to 26 degrees centigrade. But at the point 4, the relative humidity of air is very, very high. So that is why the air which is coming out of the water eliminator has got a higher value of relative humidity, but lower value of temperature. It is not 25 to 26, it may be 16 degree, 17 degree. So that is why the air which is coming out of the water eliminator is once again passed through the heating coil, where again the sensible heating of air takes place between 4 to 7. Theoretically, heating of air in the second heating process or in the second heater should have been taken place from 4 to 7. But in the actual practice, since there is a bypassing of air, so that is why, since that bypassing of air takes place, that is why the actual heating process takes place between 4 to 6. So the air which is coming out of the second heating coil will be at a suitable value of relative humidity, which is of the order of 50 to 60%, at a suitable value of temperature, which may be around 25 to 26 degrees centigrade. So the air which comes out of the heating coil like this is said to be conditioned. Such a air which comes out of the heating coil like this, we take that air to the space wherever it is to be distributed. That space we call it as the air conditioned space. So a system which is designed for with all these facilities or with all these amicabilities, that one we call it as the winter air conditioning system. So again, I would like to repeat, students, please note that if at all the question is asked on winter air conditioning system, what you are supposed to write, you should write the flow diagram or the circuit diagram of winter air conditioning system. You should represent the various processes involved in the system properly on the psychrometric chart, and you should write the proper description for the winter air conditioning system. So what are the various processes involved in the system? First one is sensible heating taking place in the first heating coil. Theoretically it should have been between 1 to 3, but in the actual practice it is between 1 to 2. What is the second process? Second process is the adiabatic humidification process. Theoretically it is between 2 to 5, but after water elimination it is between 2 to 4 only. So adiabatic humidification process is 2 to 4. Then again one more heating in the second heating coil. Theoretically it should have been between 4 to 7, but in the actual practice it is between 4 to 6. So these three processes are to be represented properly on the psychrometric chart. So this is about the description of the different summer air conditioning system and winter air conditioning system. That means that now we have considered the description, working principle of schematic diagram, working principle and the representation of various processes on the psychrometric chart for three systems. The first one is summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather. Second one is summer air conditioning system for hot and wet weather. Third one is winter air conditioning system. So in the next session we try to consider certain numerical problems on summer air conditioning system for hot and dry weather, as well as for hot and wet weather, as well as on winter air conditioning system. So let me complete here and we will meet in the next session. In the next session we will take up the numerical problems on these air conditioning systems. Thank you, Vanita.